Hello students, in this part of the lecture we'll continue with the same topic, that is connective tissue. And in this lecture, in connective tissue we'll be learning about the dense connective tissue and the skeletal connective tissue. Dense or the fibrous connective tissue is different from the loose connective tissue. And how it is different? In the loose connective tissue we had bulk of matrix, but if we talk about dense or fibrous connective tissue, we have more fibers as compared to the cells and the matrix. And as you all remember, these three are the basic components of the connective tissue: cells, matrix and fibers, right? So these dense connective tissues, they are of two types: tendons and ligament. Always to remember about tendon and ligament, remember TBM and LBB. TBM means tendon connects bones to muscles, right? And ligament connects bones to bones. So tendons, they are the tissue that connects your skeletal muscles to your bones, right? These are the thick bundle of white collagen fibers. Now always remember, collagen fibers, they are the white fibers and they are tough and non-elastic. Collagen has to be tough and non-elastic because on one side it is connected to your muscles and on the other side it is connected to your bones. So you all know the movement in your body, the locomotion is brought about by the muscles. And the muscles have the property to contract. So when the muscles contract, they pull the tendon so that tendon can enable the movement of your bone. So the structure which is tendon has to be tough and non-elastic, right? The second one is the ligament. Ligament connects your bones to bones. And it consists of yellow elastin fibers. So when a structure has to one bone is non-elastic structure, so when two non-elastic structures, they have to move, so there has to be something in between which is elastic. So these ligaments, they are made up of yellow elastin fibers, which is responsible for the elasticity. Okay, so always remember that collagen fibers, these are the fibers responsible for strength, and the elastic or the elastin fibers to provide the elasticity. Okay, so these were the two types of the dense or the fibrous connective tissue. Why are they called as fibrous? Because they have more fibers as compared to the cells and matrix. They are of two types: tendon and ligament. The next tissue is a supportive connective tissue. Supportive connective tissue, as the name tells us, gives support to our body. This tissue consists of bones and cartilage and gives a framework to our body. Framework to the body means these two structures are responsible to give a proper shape to our body. Okay? The second point for supportive connective tissue is that it gives support, as the name tells us, responsible. So this tissue is responsible to provide the framework and also responsible to provide the support. Bones, they are present everywhere in the body. They make the skeletal system. And the cartilage, they are present between the bones. They are present between two bones. So wherever in our body we have presence of the joints, all those places we have the presence of cartilage. Cartilage, apart from being between the bones or present at the joint, they are also present as your nose and your ear. Okay, and together these bones and cartilage, they bring about the movement and locomotion. You all might be aware about what is movement and locomotion. Movement means when you stand at a place and move your body parts, that is called as a movement. Means there is no change in the position. On the other hand, if you move from one place to the another place, that is called as a locomotion. So change in position is called as locomotion. And being stationary at a place and moving your body part is called as movement. So for movement and locomotion, which tissue is responsible? Your supportive connective tissue, that's your bone and the cartilage. So we'll be discussing about the structures of bone and cartilage. The first structure is the bone. Okay, bone is a porous tissue and it has good supply of the blood because it has presence of the blood vessels. This is the structure of a single bone cell. Okay, single bone cell, which is a osteocyte, sometimes also referred as osteoblast. Okay, now this osteocyte or a bone cell is present inside a cavity, and that cavity is called as lacuna. Okay, if you see one single bone cell, this one single bone cell which is present inside the lacuna secretes some substances. And these substances forms the matrix. Now, what are these substances? These substances, they are the mixture of organic and inorganic substances. Okay, now one single bone cell, it has certain cytoplasmic projections. These cytoplasmic projections that projects out of the cell, they are called as a canaliculi. So one bone cell is present in a space which is called as lacuna and has certain cytoplasmic projections called as canaliculi, and this cell secretes some substances that forms the calcified matrix of the bone. Okay. The matrix of the bone consists of the inorganic and organic substances. Inorganic substances, they are the salts of calcium and phosphate, and organic substance is the protein which is osteine. This is the one bone, one long bone which has a marrow. All the long bones, they have two marrows, yellow marrow and the red marrow. Yellow marrow forms your WBC and red marrow forms your RBC. If you look at the structure of the bone, your bone structure consists of many osteons. Okay, these circular structures that you see over here, these are called as a osteons, and there are many osteons inside the bones. Now we'll take a look at one single osteon to understand the structure in a better way. One single osteon has presence of the central cavity which is called as the Havergian canal. Okay, this is the Havergian canal, and this Havergian canal consists of the blood vessels, it consists of the nerves, and it also consists of the lymph vessel. Okay, Havergian canal is surrounded by certain layers, certain circular structures, and these circular structures, if we talk about these circular structures, they are called as a concentric lamellae, also called as a lamellae. Okay, these are the concentric lamellae, and on these concentric lamellae your bone cells are arranged. So if you see these structures, these circular structures present over your concentric lamellae, these are the bone cells. Now, the entire matrix of your bone consists of the salts of calcium and phosphate that makes your bone very, very hard. So, if the nutrients are present over here, why are they present over here? Because you have the presence of the blood. So, the nutrients have to reach from the Havergian canal to all the cells because the bone cells are living. So, how are they going to reach? They are going to reach through the canaliculi. Canaliculi, they are the tiny canals containing cytoplasmic processes of the osteocytes that we have discussed previously. So through the canaliculi, the nutrients from the Havergian canal reach the osteocytes. Okay, and lacuna, as we have discussed, this is a space containing the osteocytes. So these were the few labelings which is connected to one osteon. Okay, Havergian canal, it consists of the blood vessels, nerves and the lymph vessel. It is surrounded by the concentric lamellae, which consists of the empty space called as lacuna. And inside lacuna, you have presence of the bone cell, which is osteocyte. Osteocyte is connected to the Howardian canal for the nutrients with the help of the canaliculi. Okay, now our second structure is the cartilage. Cartilage is a soft structure, it is a rubbery structure. If we compare cartilage and the bone, bones are more harder, but cartilage, they are soft and rubbery. Why your bones are very hard structure and why cartilage is a rubbery structure, that we will see. Cartilage is tough, hard, but flexible. And the cells of the cartilage, they are called as a chondrocytes. These chondrocytes, they are located inside the lacuna. As in the structure of the bones, we had presence of the lacuna where osteocytes were present. In the same way, here also we have presence of the lacuna. But inside the lacuna, there may be one cell, there may be two cells, or even sometimes the lacuna is empty also. Okay, so lacuna, these are the fluid filled spaces which contains the chondrocytes. And chondrocytes, they are the cells of the cartilage. Cartilage, the matrix of the cartilage consists of the protein chondrin and also has presence of the fibers. Why fibers are present in the cartilage? Because of the presence of the fibroblasts that we have discussed in the areolar and adipose tissue. So wherever we have presence of the fibers, all those places you will also have the presence of the fiber secreting cell, which is called as a fibroblast. Now coming to the point, why cartilage is rubbery? Cartilage is rubbery because of the presence of the fibers. Remember which fiber makes a structure elastic? It is elastin fibers. So cartilage has presence of the elastin fiber, which makes cartilage rubbery and flexible structure. Now cartilage is a non-porous tissue. Bone was porous tissue because of the presence of the blood vessel. But cartilage is a non-porous tissue. That means blood vessels are absent in cartilage. So how the nutrients are going to reach the cells, that is chondrocyte? The nutrients, they reach with the help of a process which is called as diffusion. So through diffusions, the nutrients reach the chondrocytes. That's all for today. We'll be learning about the fluid connective tissue in the next lecture.